We were studying Vivekachudamani of Shankaracharya, and he is telling that mind alone is responsible for bondage, and it is the mind which is responsible for liberation. Through mind we get bondage, and through mind we can attain liberation. Mukti hi karaphalayate, just like a fruit on the palm of one's hand, we can attain liberation if we give up all the impurities in the mind. What are the impurities? Desires. And that we have to do prayatnena, by constant effort. Mokshaika satya visheshu ragam nirmulya sanyasya cha sarva karma sat shraddhaya yah shravanadi nishtho rajaswabhavam sadunoti buddhehe. Aika saktya, one-pointed devotion, concentration, focus to moksha. A person who has one-pointed concentration or focus to liberation, meaning cessation of repeated births and deaths, and nirmulya visheshu ragam. Nirmulya, mula means roots, nirmulya means to uproot. So uprooting ragam, attachment to visheshu, to sense objects, sanyasya cha sarva karma, and giving up all actions. What does this mean, giving up all actions? Actions means actions which are prescribed in the scriptures, or which may not be prescribed in the scriptures, but actions which are kamya karma, means actions which are done with a desire, with an objective. So in the scriptures, in the Vedas, it has been told, agnihotra juhuyama, agnihotram juhuyat. There is a sacrifice called agnihotra juhuyat. You have to perform this agnihotra. Why? Swarga kamaha. People who want to attain heaven, swarga, they need to perform agnihotra hotram juhuyat. Agnihotram juhuyat. Perform this sacrifice of Agnihotra to attain heaven. This is told in the Vedas. So person who is performing this, there is another sacrifice or Vedic sacrifice called Putra Kameshti Yagam, Yajna or Yaga, Putra Kameshti. What is Putra? Putra Kameshti. The desire is Putra Kama, Putra. I want an offspring, I want a person who will continue the lineage. So, I don't have this person, so this person does a Vedic sacrifice and gets a child. That is called Putra Kameshti Yajna. Now, that is done with a specific purpose. Then there are Vedic sacrifices for rain, for so many other things. So all this is done for desire. Nowadays we may not do sacrifice, but you go to a temple. Yesterday was Ganesha Chaturthi, you know, the celebration of Ganesha, the worship of Ganesha. So you go to a temple, you say Ganapati Pappa Morya Agle Barastu Jaldiya, something like that.
Lokariya.
Huh?
Lokariya.
Punara Varsha Lokariya. So you say that, and why do you say that? You say because you have something in the mind, okay, I should pass this examination, or I should get this promotion, or I should get this person in marriage, etc. These ideas you have got. So these desires. So nirmulya ragam, giving up attachment, and also sanyasya sarva karma, giving up all kinds of action. Sa shraddhaya, just by giving up actions with desire, which itself is a very, very difficult thing to do, and giving up attachment will not help. So what you should do? Sa Shraddhaya. You should have Shraddha. Shraddha. Shraddha means what? Swamiji says again and again that it is a word which cannot be translated. So loosely translated, it can be translated as faith, but it is not faith. Shraddha. In our scriptures, it is told, Shastreshu Guru Vakyeshu Vishwasaha. Faith in scriptures and also in the teachings of Guru. Shastreshu Guru Vakyeshu Vishwasaha. But it is not the only thing. There is something more to this Shraddha. And the best example is in the Katha Upanishad. When Nachiketa sees that his father, who is supposed to give best things in sacrifice, gives things which are completely useless. When people gift, most of them, they gift things like that, which is totally useless, they give a gift. So double purpose. You are also trashing that item and you are also gifting someone something. So that is done. And then Nachiketa sees and Shraddha Avivesha. He was overwhelmed by Shraddha. He was overwhelmed by the idea that this is not what should be given in sacrifice. So my father is doing something wrong. And what was the approach? How did he approach his father? He did not say, oh, father, you are doing all stupid things. You don't have any brain, etc. Many of us do that. But he did not do that. He said, okay, you are supposed to give the best in the sacrifice. So I am your best possession. So who are you giving me to? That was the question Nachiketa asked. So sa Shraddhaya, with Shraddha, you should have Shraddha. Yaha Shravanadi Nishto, Shravanadi. In the scriptures it is told, Srotavya Mantavya Nididhasitavya. You have to hear, you have to contemplate, and you have to meditate. Nididhyasitavya. So this is Tavya, means it is an injunction, it is an order given to you. First you listen the instructions from the mouth of the Guru, and then you, that is Shrotavya, Shravana. Then Mantavya, then you ponder over it, contemplate on it. And then Nididhyasitavya, then you enter into a sustained long meditation, prolonged meditation on the import, on the meaning of what has been told to you. That, so Shravanadi Nishto, a person should have Nishtha. So people, they get mantra, they start meditating and they say, what happened, what happened? So long back we had two brahmacharis in one of our centers, and two brahmacharis, they were sitting in the temple, and one person says, you see, if I first get the realization, they just joined brahmacharis. So they said, if I first get the realization, then I will tell you, and if you get, you wake me up and you give me whatever you have got. It's so simple. That's what they thought. So he is sitting like this, closing his eyes, and Navandan is looking at him. Anything is happening. So that's what. So this Nishtha, we don't have this steadfastness, regularity. Regularity. A person has to regularly do these things. Not one day or twice. Why? Because we have been doing the opposite thing quite regularly. In fact, we are so religious and regular about this, of running after the sense objects. So if you have to get beyond that, if you have to become free of that, you have to do this also regularly. Why is it that, what happens if a person is prescribed some antibiotics or any medicine, and the person does not take the dosage properly, what happens? No. You become immune to that medicine. If you do that sometimes, if you do that frequently, then the medicine no more has any effect on your body. Because the body has become immune to that medicine. So that is why it should never be done. You should always take the dosage properly. Otherwise, what will happen? Body, just like you give vaccination. What is vaccination? You are giving the same bacteria or virus in a controlled quantity. Similarly, the medicine, when given in wrong dosages or irregularly taken, then it loses its effect. Similarly, the medicine of mantra or japa or meditation or this contemplation, if not done regularly, it will become like what? It loses its effect. What happens? You say, you know, I go to Ramakrishna mission. I know all the Swamis there. I am so close to them. What is the use? Some people say, oh, this Swami, I saw him since he was Brahmachari. You know, me, I have seen him since he was like Brahmachari. So whenever somebody tells this to me, I say, okay, so what happened? He has become a Swami, or he has grown in spirituality, and what, you are still a fool. Yeah, nothing has happened and you are still seeing, see, I have seen him like a Brahmachari. So what? So that is the thing what happens if you don't have regularity, if you don't practice regularly. You think that you have acquired something, but this is not a path of acquisition. This is a path of giving up. This is a path of attaining something which is already there. So there is dross or rubbish which is covering your true personality. To remove that, that is what we do in spiritual life. And that will not happen if there is no nishtha. If there is no nishtha. Some people take the idea of accepting all faiths or traditions of Sri Ramakrishna totally in a wrong way. So if you go to some devotees' houses, they will have a shrine room and there will be all the gods and goddesses imaginable in that shrine, and in some corners Sri Ramakrishna also will be sitting. That doesn't help, because you lose focus, you lose nishtha, you lose steadfastness. So nishtha is very necessary. And then rajasvabhavam, you need to have controlled dhunoti. You need to have destroyed, completely annihilated, the rajasvabhava, the rajas nature, rajasic nature of buddhehe. What is the rajasvabhava of buddhi? Rajaguna, or the quality of rajas, is characterized by a predominance of activity. There is a lot of activity. So what does buddhi, which is predominantly rajasic, do? That buddhi simply thinks, makes plans of making new and new things, possessing new and new things, and starting new and newer projects. So that buddhi, which is constantly going in different direction, bahu shakha in Gita, it is told bahu shakha, it is going, it is dissipated in different directions. That buddhi is the buddhi or the intellect which is characterized by rajasic, rajoguna. So that rajasic temperament has to be removed, it has to be destroyed. Dhunoti, it has to be destroyed. So first you should have a one-pointed focus. Second, you should have dispassion. You should have no attachment to sense objects. Third, you should give up all the actions which are done with a desire, which is pretty much all the actions we do. And then you should have Shraddha. Then you should have steadfastness or regularity in all your spiritual practices, like listening or hearing and contemplating, meditating, etc. And then you should give up the rajasic temperament of your intellect. These are the things which have to be done. To do what? To make your buddhi purified. In the previous verse, Shankaracharya says, Vishuddhe Sati. That mind, if it becomes Vishuddhe Sati, if it becomes purified. So if your mind becomes pure, then you can attain. Mukti hi karafalayate. Liberation becomes like a fruit in your hand. Then Shankaracharya says, Mano mayo napi bhavet paratma. Hiyadi antavat vat parinami bhavat dukkhatmakatvat vishayatva hetoho drashta hi drishyatma tayana drishtah. Shankaracharya says, manomaya, this sheath of mind, this manomaya kosha, paratma na bhaved. It can never be the Atman or the Supreme Self. Why? This cannot be the Supreme Self. Api. So earlier, pranamaya kosha and annamaya kosha have been rejected as the true nature of the soul. He has already proved that they are not the Atman. Now here he says, even the mental sheath or the manomaya kosha is not the Atman. Why? Because Adi Antavat, it cannot be the Supreme Self, Paratma, because it has got a beginning, Adi, and it has got an end. Mind has got a beginning and it has got an end, and also Parinami Bhavat, and also it has got Parinama, modifications. Somebody comes to you and tells you are so nice, you are so well-mannered, good-natured, and you are like, oh, how good I am. And immediately somebody says, and how stupid you are, you have no common sense, and you are so foolish person, you don't know how to behave, and then you are like, So, all these things. So, Parinami Bhavat, different kinds of modifications in your mind. And dukkha atmakatvat, and also because there is pain and suffering. Why is there pain and suffering? Why do we suffer? Because we want to suffer. So there is want, and that is why we suffer. We want to suffer. So that is why there is pain, and that is why there is suffering. Vishayatva hetoho, because there is a vishaya. Because there is an object. So, that Vishayatva Hetoho, this object, we confuse it with the sense objects. Objects that which we can see. But the Atman cannot see anything other than the Atman itself. There is nothing else apart from the Atman. So there is nothing else apart from the Atman. So, drashta hi drishyatma tayana drishtah. Drashta, if you are seeing something, even in the empirical world, even in the world of Maya or ignorance, when we are seeing something, we cannot get identified with the thing which we are seeing. So if I am reading from this book, I don't say that I am this book. I could say, but then you will put me in a lunatic asylum. Otherwise, a sane person will never say that the person is this book. Book is something which I am looking at. So, drishya atmataya. Who am I? The subject is always the person who perceives, not the perceived. Subject is the perceiver, not the perceived. Na drishtah, it is not the thing which has been seen. Similarly, if that is the case, then Atman, which is the true reality, the only reality, can never be something which has been seen. So the Atman, some people say that everything is Atman. Swamiji famously in one lecture, he said, it is not that this is Atman, that is Atman, and this is Brahman, and this is Brahman. It is not. Brahman alone is. And he underlined the word is. So Brahman alone is. There is nothing else. So it is not that this is God, that is God, and everything is God. So Rasagulla is also God. Let me eat it. It is not like that. Only God is. Nothing else exists. That is the idea. So we cannot identify ourselves with sense objects, but we have to identify with Atma, Atmataya. We have to identify with Atmataya. And only when we do that, we'll be able to understand our true personality. That is what Shankaracharya says here. Then he says, buddhihi buddhindriyaihi sardham savrittihi kartra lakshanam vijnanamaya koshah syat pumsah samsara karanam. Till now he has talked about three koshas or three sheets. One is annamaya kosha, pranamaya kosha, manomaya kosha. And then comes the vijnanamaya kosha. Now he tells what is vijnanamaya kosha. Buddhihi buddhi indriyaihi. Sardham savrittihi. Buddhi, the determinative faculty. The faculty which decides what to do, what not to do. Buddhi. With its savrittihi, with its modifications, and indriyaihi, with different organs of knowledge. With different organs of knowledge, kartra lakshanam. And also, what kind of, what is the characteristic of this kosha, vijnanamaya kosha? Kartra lakshanam. This is the kosha or this is the sheath which thinks that I am the doer. So this is the sheath which has the part of ignorance, which has this idea that I do, kartaham iti manyate. In Bhagavad Gita it is told that people who are not aware of their true personality, they think that aham karta iti manyate, I am the doer. They think that I am the doer, but you are not the doer. This is all ignorance. No, there is no action and you are not the doer. So the buddhi with savrittihi, vritti means modifications. Modifications like ahankara. So buddhi says, yes, now we will do this. Now this Swami has been talking so much. Now I will ask him such a question that he will be simply floored. So a couple of days back, some devotees came and one person said, Swamiji, I have a question, very difficult question. I will ask you. And the idea is that so difficult that you are like, you will be a child. You will be just floored. So I told him that it depends on who is listening to the question. It may be difficult for you, may not be difficult. So anyway, that is the idea. So this buddhi has got the idea of ahankara, egoism. Egoism. And it also has the different kinds of modification. This should be done, that should be done, and the planning. And it has got organs of knowledge. All the organs of knowledge, five organs of knowledge, are controlled by the buddhi. These and kartra lakshanam, the idea of being the agent, that is called vijnanamaya kosha syat. Kosha has syat pum. This is called vijnanamaya kosha. It is called the sheath of vijnana or knowledge sheath, you can say so. And what does it do? Pumsaha sansara karanam. It is the cause of sansara. What is sansara? It is the repeated birth and death is called sansara, transmigration. So it is the cause of pumsaha, human beings or people's transmigration. Pumsaha is sometime, most of the time, wrongly translated as man. It need not be translated as man. It can mean woman also. Pumsaha means a person. So, sansara karanam. Like the word putra has now been understood to mean son. But actually, in early Vedic times, in the Rig Veda, etc., you find that putra can mean both son and also a daughter. So Sanskrit, like most of the classical languages, because of change in usage, the meaning, interpretation of the original text changes. So now Shankaracharya says that this is what is called Vijnanamaya Kosha. And so, Anuvrajachit Pratibimba Shaktihi Vijnana Sangyaha Prakrite Vikaraha Jnana Kriyavanaham Iti Ajasram Dehendriyadishu Abhimanyate Brisham. This Vijnana Sangyaha, that means this knowledge sheath. Sangya means that with the thing, the name, Sangya. So Vijnana Sangya means that which is called Vijnana or Vijnanamaya Kosha. It is Anuvrajachit Pratibimba Shakti. You can use the chair if you want. Anuvrajat Chit Pratibimba Shakti. It is Pratibimba. Chit Pratibimba Shakti. It is a Pratibimba or a reflection of the Chit Shakti. Power of Chit or consciousness. It is a reflection of the power of consciousness. So consciousness has got this faculty of intelligence. Not exactly faculty, but Sat Chit Ananda, we say. That is the quality of Atman. So in this, Chit is consciousness or intelligence. That intelligence is reflected in this kosha. It is reflected in Vijnanamaya kosha. And Vijnana Sange Prakriti Vikara hai. And it is a modification of Prakriti. It is a modification of Prakriti. That means, what is Prakriti? It is in the realm of ignorance or Maya. If it is a modification of Prakriti, it means it is material. It is Jada. It is not conscious. It is material. It is Jada. Insentient. Because everything which comes under ignorance or Maya is all matter. It is not conscious. Jnana Kriyavan Ahamiti Ajasram. And Jnana Kriyavan. And it is the Kriyavan, means it is Jnana Kriya. It is responsible, or it has got the function of all knowledge. Function of knowledge. Jnana Kriya. Whenever you acquire some new knowledge, or you understand something, that is why all these senses of organs of knowledge come under this kosha. So every knowledge, whatever you acquire, everything comes under this sheath. And ahamiti ajasram dehendriyadishu abhimanyate vrisham. And this, you also, because of this sheath, you also identify yourself with knowledge. And also Deha Indriya Adishu. You identify yourself with the body, Deha, and organs, and other things. Other things means your intellect and other things. Abhimanyate Brisham. And you identify with it in a big way. Brisham means large or greatly, with lot of intensity. You identify. And so, Atma, this Atma, or our true nature, is clouded by this sheath, which is the fourth sheath, Vijnanamaya kosha. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat.